Hey everyone, welcome back. In this capstone project, we will see together how to create a mobile YouTube listing app from scratch and step by step. We will create this app using Kotlin programming language and we will use the Parse platform to store the data of our mobile application. In this course, we will use the Back4App cloud service, which facilitates the use and the management of the Parse platform. Now, I will overview the final mobile app which we will create together in this capstone project. So, let's go! Now, I will open the visor tool which will display the screen of mobile phone in my computer. Note that the visor tool could be installed either on Ubuntu or Windows operating system. Here, in my case, I'm using visor under the Ubuntu operating system. So, to open the visor tool, just type visor here. As you see, the visor tool displays the screen of mobile Android phone. Now, I will open the YouTube listing app, which we will create together in this course. This is the icon of our application. I will click on it to open the app. As you see, in the main screen of our mobile app, we have a listing of the various categories of videos added to our mobile app backend. Each category has a name and a featured image. We have here three categories: Android, Arduino, and Raspberry Pi. Now, I will click, for instance, on the Android category. After clicking, I will get the list of videos belonging to this category. Note here that for each video item, we show the thumbnail image as well as the video title. To play the video, we just need to click on the corresponding item. As you see, our app loads the YouTube video in a new screen and the video is automatically displayed in full screen mode. Then, we can play the video in our app by just clicking on the play button. Now, I will return to the main screen of our mobile app by clicking twice on the back button. When I click on the Arduino category, the mobile app will display the videos belonging to this category. Here, we have just 4 videos in this category. And in the Raspberry Pi category, we have just 1 video. Now, we will see together how to add another video to our YouTube listing app. To do so, I will just search for the Raspberry Pi in the YouTube search field. We will get a list of videos speaking about the Raspberry Pi. For instance, I will add this video to our YouTube listing app. To do so, I have to click on this video. Then, I will copy the video title like this. Then, in our backend database, we just need to add a new entry in the video class. So, just click on the video class. Then click on the plus button in the bottom. Here, we will paste the title of the video. Then, we have to copy the YouTube ID of the video, which is located just after the V field in the YouTube video URL. I will copy this string, which is the YouTube ID of our video. Then, I will paste it in the YouTube ID field of the new video item. Now, we just need to affect the new video to the Raspberry Pi category. So, just click on the category class. Now, we will copy the object ID of the Raspberry Pi category. First, I need to select the corresponding Raspberry Pi category, then click on the object ID of this category item. After that, just press Ctrl+C buttons to copy the object ID. Then, click on the video class and paste the copied object ID to the category field of the new video item. Now, if I return to the Android app and return to the main screen of our app, then I click again on the Raspberry Pi category like this. We will see the video which we just added to our backend database listed in our mobile app. As you have noted here, the front end of our app is very easy to use and the management of our backend database is simple and straightforward. So, you can build an entire YouTube listing app in no time. In this video, we have seen together the main features of the YouTube listing app, which we will create together in this course. In addition, we have seen how to add a new video to the mobile app. The added video becomes directly available in the mobile front end without needing any app update. See you in the next video.